This is a movie that can't be easily understood. In the villa area with no way out, there are thousands of villas. When having got in, there's no way to get out. They will peel your heart like an onion, layer by layer. Because of shortage of money, this couple just wanna buy a normal house. They came to this area. Everything in this house satisfied them. After having a look, they decided to discuss more. Strange things happened. In this mysterious area, every villa looked the same, same color, same size. Only one thing differed, that's each house's number. They couldn't get out, every road looked like they had passed. They came back to villa number 9, at that moment, they suddenly felt very scared. They stopped. The coincidence is that they came back to the villa number 9. All might be just coincidence. No, David felt that his girlfriend was joking. Go there, I'll drive. They came back to the villa number 9 many times. It was getting dark. They kept doing that from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. The car ran out of fuel, what could they do? Think over it, what would you do if you were in this situation? Go inside first, can't stay in the car more. Lisa screamed, but only heard her echo. In a spacious place like that, how could echo be heard? Scare and nerves filled their mind. They slowly got into the room. In their mind, they always felt something would happen. Due to that, they ate strawberries in the fridge, but couldn't taste. Lisa couldn't, either like David. They felt like eating water. At night, they were lying on bed. They had never felt as quiet as that. The next day, David climbed up the roof. He wanted to see what happened from a high view. But he was surprised by the same villas in front of him. He couldn't see the end. He didn't dare to tell Lisa, it may scare her. They started to come into other houses, nothing inside. They kept doing that until afternoon from sunrise to sunset. Finally, they found a lighted house, they were relieved. Coming into the house, they realized that was still villa number 9 they had stayed. What really happened? Dad saw a barrel in the front, there were foods inside. Obviously, someone put it there for them. Lisa quickly followed the trace to find that guy. David took the barrel to the room, he intended to fire the house, and then got away. They sat quietly and looked, something vague appeared in their mind, but they knew one thing for sure. If someone was playing them, there must be someone who could get out. Their only way was to sit there, wait until the house was totally burnt. They slept on the roadside. When they woke up, another barrel like the one yesterday was in front of them. They opened it. Inside was a kid, who didn't look like human very much. They looked over. Jesus, the burnt house appeared in their eyes. Even science couldn't explain this. David wrote, "Help me," on the roof. He hoped someone could see it. Time went by. They've been in this villa for 98 days. The baby seemed to eat miraculous potions. In just a few months, it grew up like an 8-year-old child. It quickly imitated all what they did. Even a talk. It could learn and do the same. It seems to forget nothing. When meal came, it screamed, loudly. It kept screaming until the table was full of foods and then stopped. Every day, they tried any way possible to get out of this place. Whatever David destroyed would become original shape. Like nothing had happened. Facing those strange things every day, David couldn't stand anymore. He decided to lock the child in the car. But the woman didn't dare to do that. It did nothing wrong. David started to dig a hole and slept in that hole at night. He dug all day long, he didn't say anything to the others. He supposed them as not existing. The woman also couldn't recognize herself. She imitated the child to learn cat and dog language. It might be a way to release stress. The cloud here was very beautiful, but her eyes showed no hope. They'd been there for nearly 1 year. That day, the child suddenly disappeared and came back after a few hours. It brought a book to Lisa. There were bizarre letters on it and strange pictures. Human beings seem unable to make out. Lisa planned to test the child. She helped him, urged him. Obviously, he regarded her as his mom. He suddenly made a weird noise. The boy's throat gradually opened in a strange way. He was simulating a crying frog. Seeing that, Lisa was scared to death. She couldn't think of anything. Who could be calm when seeing that? Very quick, the child became an adult. Lisa forgot that the man who took her to this house looked like this child. Since then, Lisa no longer regarded this child as her son, but he thought she was his servant. Standing next to him, no sound was made. Even when eating, they didn't make any noise. It was like the other would eat that sound. That day, the boy went out. Lisa followed to see where he went. What strained her was when reaching a turn, he disappeared. When Lisa caught up with him, he was on the old road. She could hear his footsteps, but couldn't catch up with him. David had been digging for half a year. He had to do that, because that was the only way. While digging, he seemed to see something. A body. He was scared and climbed out of the hole. Lisa came back at the same time. They really needed a rest. After such a long time, scare made them exhausted. They wanted to go inside, but the door was locked. No matter how Lisa shouted, the boy just looked at her. The door was too hard to be broken. He wouldn't think about others. They then slept in car for the whole night. The next day, David fainted. He didn't wake up no matter what. Lisa knocked the door. She hoped he could help. But he rudely said, he has no use from now. Lisa collapsed after that. How could he treat them like that? He was brought up by them. Lisa hugged David. They leaned on each other. David wanted to light a cigarette, but he was too weak. He had Lisa do it for him. That night, they slept outside. The boy went out and brought a barrel with him. Another body inside. Lisa screamed mournfully, but wasn't noticed. He even imitated her. Then he put David into a bag, drained the air inside, and threw to the hole. David couldn't imagine that the hole that he dug for 8 months now is used to bury him. He left Lisa behind, alone in this world. The next day, Lisa took a weapon. Quietly, moved to the guy. Lisa was just a woman. She couldn't beat the monster or knock him down. When Lisa tried the second time, the guy was much more careful. He quickly drew a line on the ground and brought it up. Lisa saw that the space down there was not smooth. Without any word, she ran into it. After that, she reached a room, which was totally different from the old one. There was a child inside, sitting and looking at an eating woman while crying. For 1 year, finally Lisa met a normal person, but the woman saw her just like seeing a monster. At that moment, Lisa started to sink. She fell to the ground and moved to a different space. There's a 4-month-old baby inside, clapping hands. Then a monster's hands pulled Lisa to the third space, in which there's body, which scared Lisa to death. She suddenly came back to the villa number 9. She stood up, went out through the main door. That hole, that villa, nothing changed. She doubted who she was. Was she still human? She couldn't understand why she met those strange things. At that moment, the boy who became an adult completed the job of memory deleting involving Lisa and David. Then he put Lisa into a bag and threw into the hole David had dug. He buried them. What happened in that villa number 9 was like a miracle. The man drove David's car and easily left the strange villa area where they couldn't get out for 8 months. At a property center, he exchanged himself with an old man and put him into a bag. He is welcoming the next guest to see the house.